just got punched, man.
Sparring day.
This is the Schmo with the pro with the number two ranked lightweight in the world, Dustin the Diamond Poirier, here at American Top Team. How we doing?
Doing good, man. Doing good. Back to the grind.
That's right. Sparring day. Just getting busted up there.
Busting some people up. Light sparring. I don't spar unless I'm in training camp.
Well said, man. You're going to be a guest fighter over at Houston next week, UFC 247. Looking forward to chopping it up with all the media members I see.
For sure, man. I grew up not too far from Houston. Did a lot of jiu-jitsu in Houston growing up. So looking to see some familiar faces out there.
Now talk to me for a second. We haven't seen Colby Covington's face around here. You must have scared him away, man. We all know the beef there. Are we ever going to see him walking through these confines at the gym again?
I don't know. I'm sure he will. We'll see. We'll address that when it's time.
Yes. And we know you did an interview last week with MMA Junkie. You would love to have Nate Diaz as an opponent. If you don't have Nate Diaz as an opponent, because you're open to jumping weight classes, is there anybody else in mind if you don't get that fight?
I'm sure there's a bunch of people that make sense. I'm just waiting on the UFC to give me a name that I'm, you know, looking at the big picture. There's so many guys to fight, but I'm just waiting on a name. And when they offer me one, then I'll know if it's the right one or exciting fight that makes sense. And also with the Nate thing, I see articles every week about me talking about Nate. I'm not like beating the same drum over and over again. I'm not chasing a Nate fight. I said that in maybe one or two interviews, and then people keep talking about it, or people keep breaking down interviews from the past and writing new articles to try to get people to click on it. You know, for sure, I'd love to fight Nate. It's an exciting fight, but obviously the guy's not fighting, so I think, man, we got to move on from that.
What you're looking forward to is the name of the opponent, the quality of the opponent, the payday, rather than the weight class at this point. What'd you say?
Yeah, you know, for sure, paydays are always great, but I just want exciting fights as well. You know, I've been doing this a long time, and like you said, I'm still number two, so I think I'm a fight or two away from another crack at the title if it's the right opponent, the right performance. I'm just waiting on those things to come together.
You fought Khabib. You fought him well. A lot of people, I feel like, are not giving Tony Ferguson a chance in this fight. What do you make of that matchup in Brooklyn?
It's a fun fight. You know, I'm excited to see it happen, especially because it's in the lightweight division and the fight was supposed to happen so many times before. I think Tony could cause some problems for Khabib with elbows from the bottom and also just his unpredictability on the feet. He's a crazy scramble. You know, he has a crazy scrambling ability, does front rolls and just really weird stuff. But once Khabib gets his hands around Tony, I don't think Tony's going to be able to get back up, honestly. I think Khabib wins that fight. But we'll see. That's the beauty of MMA. It's the theater of the unknown in there.
Your division is stacked. You look at the top, there's a Justin Gaethje. He's sitting waiting for an opponent. What do you think is right for that man to do next?
Dude, that's tough to say. Everybody runs with their own career the way they want to go. If he wants to wait for a title shot, you know, he's beat some big names in some impressive ways. So, I mean, he might be next. I know Dana said otherwise, but it's just so unpredictable, this sport. You know, I don't know what's going to happen in a week from now, much less that far down the line. But I'm here at American Top Team. I was in Louisiana healing up from my hip surgery for a while, but I've been back here about a month now, and I'm going to stay here until I fight again. So I'm just going to keep getting better and take it from there, man. Just hoping for an offer from the UFC and hoping to get better every day here on the mats.
You still pushing your teammate Jorge Gamebred Masvidal? He's had quite a 2019. What's it like training with that guy in the gym currently?
It's great, man. He's a pioneer and a real martial artist. He's always learning. He's a student of the game, so it's good to be around guys like that. I'm always learning stuff from him and going back and forth with techniques, just sharpening each other. It's good to have guys like that on the mat, and here at American Top Team, we have a bunch of these kind of guys, you know, guys who've been doing this for a long time, guys like Thiago Alves and, you know.
Now doing the bare knuckle fighting.
Yeah, man, that's intense. I went to my first show in Mississippi a few months ago, and that was extreme, man.
You think that's a sport that's here to stay, or it's just going to be temporary?
You know, I had to educate myself a little bit on the background of bare knuckle fighting with the Queensbridge or whatever, Queensberry rules, I think it is. I didn't know that boxing started out like that, and then, you know, Sullivan and the whole lineage of that title and all that stuff. It's pretty interesting now that I know a little bit about the history. But being a mainstream thing, I don't know, man. It's vicious to see in person. You know, I watching it on the pay-per-views online is one thing, but being there in person and sitting front row and seeing these guys crack each other and, you know, it's intense.
I know you're a big fan of boxing, too. Who do you think's got a stronger punch, Francis Ngannou or Deontay Wilder?
Well, I only know one of the guys you just mentioned punches like a Ford Taurus. Or whatever they said he punches like. I got to go with Deontay Wilder in that one.
Well said. Final message for the Diamond fans out there worldwide.
Hey, I'm coming back. It's going to be a great year, 2020. I want to fight 3 times. Just waiting on the UFC to give me a call. But I promise you'll be some exciting fights this year.
He's the pro. I'm the Schmo. At ATT, we're out.